Stand by. Stand by music. Ready two. Up on a track 31. Standing by for the pan. Ready five. Have a great show, folks. Here we go. And roll it.
Well, I've been a television director for a long, long time.
I started in the middle of the 81-82 season, and I've been with SNL for 34 seasons.
This is my 20th season.
It's my 17th.
I've been here 22 years, which sounds crazy to say it out loud, half my life. So Wednesday is read-through day. All the writers the night before are writing all the sketches that they've pitched to the host and to Lauren.
We come out of that read-through. Lauren meets with the host, with the other producers on the show first.
And basically, he's now, with index cards, laid the show out. What he wants in the first act, second, third, putting all the pieces of the puzzle together.
We generally will mount anywhere from 10 to 13 pieces in a given show.
And for the first time, the hair and makeup people, and the wardrobe people, and the set design people, special effects people find out what we're actually doing. They start from scratch Wednesday night.
As the selections are being made, I lay out the studio, where everything's gonna go into the studio. And I also dedicate an amount of time for each sketch to be rehearsed over the course of Thursday and Friday.
So on Thursdays, always rehearse music, we'll do promos, and then we'll probably do about four sketches. Don will go out and mark it on the floor and block it out for the first time with the cast. He has it in his brain, but now he's relaying it to all of them where he wants them to be and walk.
Moving actors around, making sure that they get to the right place at the right time. It's that kind of physical moving of the chess pieces.
So then he'll come back into the control room and we'll put it on camera for the first time. So I'm timing basically the scripts in front of me and I'm timing every line.
You should put a bridge after that part.
Shut up, Reb!
Just to know how long it takes for them to say this and to this and to this, because what we read on Wednesday is not what airs on Saturday night at all. Like, sometimes it is completely different.
Saturday, we come back in and suddenly the studio is filled with full sets that come to life.
On a Saturday, it's the first time we're seeing everything.
Yeah, three sets of cue cards, all wardrobe, all the special effects. We're just prepping to make sure that everything's in place and ready to go for Don.
Ultimately, it all has to come together on Saturday at 1 o'clock with all its elements, because it's the first time we have all the elements.
For our Saturday run-through, you basically have one shot. One shot to get it right, one shot with costumes, with set, with props, with everything. We did this Forrest Gump, Jeff Sessions cold open. And it was basically Kate as Jeff Sessions sitting on a park bench like Forrest Gump.
Hello, my name's Jeff, Jeff Sessions. Would you like a chocolate?
And the transition for that was gonna be a bus. They were at a bus stop. So it was basically this cardboard thing that would be passed through the set and grabbed on the other end like it was stopping into the station and pulling off. The bus is on a completely different set, in front of a green screen. We tried rehearsing and it was a disaster. The bus would stop, the bus jumped, we just couldn't get the rhythm. And it's the cold open, and the cold open and the monologue are very important to the show. I mean, they start the show, they set the tone. So that was one where Kenny, who was already, like, we were running late in run-throughs, and he's always the one who tries to say, okay, we gotta go, we gotta go, we gotta go. He's like, we gotta do it again.
And we do a dress rehearsal at 8 o'clock Saturday evening.
It's Saturday Night Live.
This is the first time audience comes in.
After dress, the PAs, Janine and her group, have timed the show.
Between dress and air, we go into a meeting in Lauren's office. He knows how long dress is.
Lauren will throw out two or three sketches entirely, reorder the rest of the show.
We finish that meeting by 11, so that the changes that have happened subsequent to dress can be absorbed. Cue cards, cast. We come out of that meeting, the show is still 5 to 8 minutes long.
Go into air, a live show, we're 7 minutes long. Where are you gonna find it, right?
When I was interviewing directors to take over the show, I said, there's nothing I can do to prepare you for what's gonna happen between dress and air. Your book will have been taken away from you. Half of it's taken away right after Weekend Update during dress rehearsal. And all the cuts and changes are being put in no matter what it is. Whether it affects a camera shot or not, there'll be a post-it on that page. It's a sea of post-its. And you have to absorb all those, pass that information on to the camera folks. You have like 10 minutes to do it.
Turn the page, a line will be crossed out, and turn a page, a new joke is written in here. I'll turn the page, I'll say, wait, it's a different ending for the sketch. How are we gonna do that?
There was one that was so bad, it was from Colin Jost. We made him sign it. scribble and arrows and go to the star here and go, like, it was crazy. And I was like, you're gonna sign this, we're gonna post it, and we're gonna tell you never do this again because this is insane.
The domino effect of every change is something that Jenna and I have to be aware of, not just on the floor, but for every department, make sure that every department knows there's been this change.
Hey, Mike. Laura wants to know how much they need on time.
He wants to see how things play out. Is this dress audience the same as the air audience is? Are they responding to the same things? Because it's a completely different audience. They literally load out dress and load in air in an hour to get ready for this live show. We get through the first few acts. We get through the first musical guest. We get through update.
People wear glasses that are ugly. We're wigging up that I'm Michael Caine.
I'm Kyle Jessica Knight.
After update, we're going to start to make decisions on what we're going to have to do to get the show down to time.
A bunch of producers come in, and they're all huddled. Huddled over my seat in the control room.
What we shoot for is nothing less than 10 seconds to say goodnight. In order to do that, we have to hit the last commercial break at 12:59:34. We try to know where the writers for the last two pieces are in case we need to make cuts, that kind of thing. And at that point, you can't be thinking in terms of a cut here, a little line here. You have to be talking chunks.
Decisions are made on the fly about what gets cut and what gets smoothed around. And while I'm still calling camera shots and trying to stay with the action as it is happening on the air, I know that right down the line here at the end of the console, people are making decisions about what to add and what to cut.
And this is while the live show's happening. So the show's going. The director's cutting.
Wait a minute, well, Kyle and Alex just ends with, oh yeah, oh well, somebody's gotta help me here, where are the writers?
Like, everything's happening, we're having this huddle like 10 feet from the director. How he concentrates on what he's doing, I have no idea.
And so there is that sense of potential panic throughout the 90 minutes.
You can't get to his book while he's going. Like, he's calling camera three, he's turning pages on his book. 9 times out of 10, these changes are being put into these books or relayed to these people in the commercial break before the sketch is gonna happen, which is insane.
There's no way I can articulate what we have to do to get this on the air, and I'm just gonna have to do it as it happens, and I do it as it happens.
You can never underestimate what a challenge it is to pull this off week after week, that all these things coalesce at the same time in the same place and that it works in front of an audience. And I'll tell you, when it's firing on all cylinders, it's like music.
Thank you all. Terrific show.